Hey everybody, and welcome to this masterclass from Hillsong Film and TV. This time we'll be hearing from
My name is Shane Smith.
Among other shows on the Hillsong channel, Shane heads up the production for Cafe Theology, a show with a lot of chroma keying involved. Here's Shane and his favorite ice cream flavor.
Cotton candy. It's very sweet. Most people hate it because it's too sweet, but I'm a sweet guy, so I can handle it. The whole idea behind the show in terms of like a visual style is that when you're in a really good conversation, everything else like slows down and your focus, you know, narrows into that conversation with that person, right? We shot Pastor Terry delivering to camera, and then the idea was to simply mask him out and have the patrons in the cafe behind him slow them down. Any of this or moving hands or his head moving became quite difficult to deal with. So we decided to go with a partial green screen where his head was still in the real space, but everything from his shoulders down was behind a green screen so that when he talked with his hands or moved around, we could easily overlap that with slow motion footage behind him. Traditionally, when you're gonna do some chroma keying, you're gonna use the Keylight effect. So I've picked my green and just look at final result. Now you see how it's made this transparent, but I've got all this other transparency going on. So normally I would go into screen matte here and then adjust the black levels. So this is adjusting getting a pure black. Now there's no real noise here in the black, so I don't really need to raise it too much, just a few points. But now if I adjust the whites, that's gonna start cleaning up all the white areas. So I wanna ideally get this down so it was all completely white. Now see, as I get closer, I start reintroducing white back into here. So I'm gonna back this off a bit. And I'm actually gonna back it off quite a bit because I'm only really worried about the green screen itself, because I'm gonna mask all this else off and we'll address the window later. So just getting a good clean key there. We have our final result there. Now for this, I wanted to keep some in the real space, but using natural lines in the image to hide any of my seams. So that's why I'm using the edge of the table here. And I'm just gonna kind of cut across the table. And then I wanna mask inside of the green screen itself. Now, and if I go here and I'm gonna use the line of the window to hide that mask as well. Go across here. I have no real good way of getting across here, so I'm just gonna cut straight across there. Okay, so now I've masked out the importance. So this is what I want to be real, to sit on the background plate. So now it's actually, he's fitting into the environment pretty well. Now the next issue is that we have these holes in the window, and that's because there's actually green in the trees and everything outside. So we had to create another layer to fill in those holes. And all that was a very small unkeyed section that we're laying on the back layer that appears through here to fill in those little holes in the background. So yeah, that multi-layer keying is good if you have the time. But if you have a more difficult shot to work with, it'll give you a better result. Some general things when lighting for green screen. Well, first off, always have your subject far enough away from the green screen. That's something that a lot of people have trouble with. You need to be at least 2 meters or 6 feet away from the screen itself, because the screen will cast spill onto the subject and that'll create some issues.
We've got these lights here that are primarily focused on the green screen itself, and then the front lighting here. We've got some good crisp backlighting that's hitting me from above. So this is a pretty good setup for green screen lighting. What works well is having a light on either side, because you can never really light a green screen with one light. If you only have one light to work with, then you'll need to find a way of hanging it from above to get a more even dispersion on that. Another thing to really keep in mind is you don't want to overexpose the green screen. and especially if your subject has blonde hair. Now, there's actually like a lot of green hue in blonde hair. So if you have a very fair-skinned, you know, blonde-haired individual in front of your screen, you definitely don't want to overlight your green screen, and you want it to be a little bit more of a darker green, and you'll get a better key. Throwing a lot of light at a green screen might cause you more troubles, because then that color is more similar to a color in skin tones and in hair. But a darker green, you have a better chance of getting a clean key.